I want to get you the very latest on the pandemic tonight. The average number of daily new COVID cases in Chicago is up to 903 now. That is up more than 70% from last week. Despite a continuing increase in COVID hospitalizations across Illinois, the number of patients in the city dropped 40% in the past week. The average positivity rate now at 4.1%. That's up from 3.3% last week. And we're also learning new information today about the effectiveness of the vaccine against the variant. And Dina, you have more on that.
Well, Ray, right now, more than 40 people in the U.S. have been infected with the Omicron variant, and more than 75% of them were vaccinated. The good news, nearly all had mild symptoms. And today, Pfizer announced its vaccine booster shot increases antibody protection against COVID by 25 times. That good news is coupled with results from a local researcher testing blood samples against the Omicron variant. He says it's important to discuss antibodies, but it's equally critical to focus on cellular immunity, which lasts longer than the initial vaccine antibody boost.
COVID infections and vaccines boost short-term antibodies. Those antibodies trigger long-term immune memory in the form of B and T cells.
So the immune system has two main arms that are really important for protecting us against SARS.
Breakthrough infections show the process in action as vaccinated people whose antibodies wane test positive for COVID, but T and B cells help them not get as sick.
So again, that's why we're seeing that there are breakthrough infections, but we're not seeing a dramatic rise in hospitalizations and deaths because cellular immune defenses don't go down as much over time. So we're developing new tests of cellular immunity that we hope we can roll out in the community to facilitate our understanding of who's immune, who might need to get boosted, how the vaccine is working in the general population.
Until that test is ready, Northwestern Medicine's Dr. Thomas McDade and his team are analyzing immunity in blood samples of COVID survivors, vaccinated, and boosted patients.
What we're seeing with Omicron is similar to the story with Delta over the summer. The variant has changed a bit, which means that the vaccine that we all received, which was generated against the original version of the virus, isn't quite as effective. But it's still very effective, especially with our cellular immune defenses.
The blue line represents a blood sample before and after vaccination. The pattern is similar to the red line, which represents someone who recovered from COVID, then got the vaccine. After the first dose, a small response, a little better for the previously infected. After the second shot, antibodies shoot up, but they wane over the next 6 months.
Over the summer, antibodies start to come down over time, as we know, and we're back basically where we were after the first vaccine dose.
Then, with a booster?
Once you get a booster dose, about a week later, your antibodies go up to over 100. So that's four times higher than where you were after full vaccination with dose two. And it's 25 times higher than where you were the week before because your antibodies have gone down over time.
The original vaccine was not designed to target the hundreds of mutations in Omicron, but
you have strength in numbers here, even if the fit isn't exactly right. If we increase our antibodies overall, even if they're not a perfect match for Omicron, they should be effective at preventing infection.
Keeping up with a rapidly mutating virus is like focusing on the flu, only faster.
We all have some experience with it, particularly through childhood, and we carry that forward. And that's where we'll get to eventually with COVID-19. But the more people who can get vaccinated globally, the less virus will be in circulation, the fewer opportunities it will have to evolve a new variant that escapes our immune defenses, and then we'll all be in better shape.
The bottom line, just like it's not realistic to think we'll never get a cold or the flu, early vaccine success may have unrealistically raised expectations we would not get COVID. Experts say COVID is likely here to stay.